Hello my friends, welcome on this video tutorial today. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and today I will show you the best free video editor for YouTubers, vloggers, for everybody who wants to record video with camera. If you don't want to spend a lot of money buying a license to use Adobe Premiere or some professional video editor softwares, then here today I will show you the best free video editor that I really like. I will guide you on this video tutorial and I will show you step by step how it works. I will make a review today for this program, VideoProc Vlogger. VideoProc Vlogger is a freeware, it's totally free, you don't have to pay any money, and I really like this software. I tested and it's great. There are some very nice features on it. It's very nice, guys. Let's continue and see directly how this software works. Let's go here on this website. It's videoproc.com. It's from DigiArt company. This DigiArt company has also a free video editor, but also is a video converter all in one. And here we can go here on the video editor and then get this one, VideoProc Vlogger. Click here and you will see this windows, and then click here free download. Here you will see it's 140 megabytes. So after we download the setup, just go here on the folder and double click here on VideoProc Vlogger, and the installation we will start it directly. You will see this windows. I have read and accept. If we want to customize, just click here, customize, but let it as it is, click install. If you don't want to spend a lot of money on buying a video software program, here it is, VideoProc is for free. Let's go here and click launch. And let's see, VideoProc Vlogger. Okay, what do we have to do? Just click here on the top, click here on the new project, and then create new project. Here on new project, choose the location of your project. Here, put a name, choose video resolution. If you want to work with 4K a video, here it is the preset. If you want to work with 2K video, if you record the footage with HD footage, you choose this project. I will work here with full HD video resolution and choose your frame rate, and then create a new project. Here it is. So now in the left area, we have the media library, transition, titles, and effects. Here is the timeline. Here we can put all the videos, video track, overlay track, audio track, and everything. We can put it here. But for the moment, let's go directly to the point. Let's get a video, go here on the media library and click plus here, and then just go to your footage. I will copy the path, but if you want, you can just drag and drop here, but I will do it on the regular way, open up, and then I will choose this fish. I like this one. And here it is. We have video, picture, music, subtitle. So we can put subtitle here if you want. So now let's take this video, drag here and bring it here on the timeline, here on the video track. You can put this one here on overlay also, but I will put it here on the video track. So here it is. Now we have view here, and in the other side we have all the options, opacity and things. You can change the color and filter if you want directly as a preset. Is very nice, guys, because you know we need to work fast, we don't have time, so everything it's time. So here it is. You have color here, you have transform here, rotation, and you have scale if you want. That's cool, I like that option also. You have volume if you have music, you have reverse play here, and play speed. It's very important, play speed. Yeah, okay, I have the fish here. Let's put some music. I have to put some music here. Go open up footage again, and I have bubbles here, and I will drag and drop here on the music, and look at this, directly it's listed on the music area. Okay, so another thing, what we have to do, let's put an extra footage here. I will make an editing, put it here. Look at this, another video. So what we have to do, I just want to put some music here, drag this music and paste it here on audio track and let's hear it. Wait a second, go. Okay. So now I want a transition from this video to the other one. So let's go here on the transition areas. I like here dissolve. Dissolve is very useful, very used on Adobe Premiere. So nice, we have dissolve here because I need the dissolve and I put it on the front and also in the end, I use the dissolve, but I will use this glitch. Or yeah, I like this one, glitch option. Wow, glitch memories, swap. There are all of these guys are free. That's nice. Okay, let's do some zoom, zoom in, zoom, zoom, zoom here, and let's see the transition here. And I need some more moments. Okay, you can choose the time of transition here, drag it here a little bit and you can make it more bigger. Okay, let's go again. Okay, so what we have also here, we have split, if you want to split the video. Yeah, click on the video, click split, it's cool. Also, what we have crop, if you want to crop. And you can do a custom crop on the video and click apply. You have colors directly. If you want to change the color on the video, you can do it fast. Click apply here. And then you can record. There is a microphone button here. Okay, record. Let's do a record. I need this option. It's very, very good. Choose your microphone, click start. And here I am now. I'm recording for this. So let's hear. Save, click start, and here I am now. I'm recording for this.
It works.
So let's hear. Good, it works. Okay. So what we have next? We have transition, we have titles. Let's see if I need some title. Look at this, you can put title directly here. But title has another area. Here it is, title. Choose your text. Miami. Okay, click apply here. But you can manipulate the text if you want. Choose your text how you want it, standard or yeah, I like, let's use this one here and click yes, starting. Also, you can edit this text if you want. Choose the position, horizontal. Yeah. And you can choose the font. Choose the font you like. Here it is, you can deal with title. So what we have next is subtitle. Go here on titles. And here you have some subtitles. Let's drag this subtitle here. The subtitle with yellow. And here is the horizontal. And also here is the size of the font, choose it here, and then here is the subtitle. Here you can edit the subtitle. Go to effects, what we have? Effects, we have an effect track here, drag and drop it here. Let's see. Nice. Oh, cool. We have a lot of effects here. And here I am now, I'm recording for this. But what I like is that you can put effects in different track. You don't have to put directly on the video, but you put it on the different tracks. That's great. This thing, it makes this software very nice. And also transition, titles, and effects. There are a bunch of this. So what we have next, let's say we are done with this video and we want to export it. Now we need to use it. Click here on the export. Look at this, how easy it is. It's here. Export is here. Click here on export. And then you will see, you put your name of the video, save the video, whatever you want here. I like it here on this footage folder, select folder. And I will type finished work video. I need format MP4. I like that MP4. It's quality, medium. I want it high. Yeah, high quality. And I like this H200. And leave the video codecs AVC. That's cool. 30 frame per second, I want it 30, and then audio, you can choose MP3 or AAC. I will let it AAC, I like better quality with lower bitrate. Enable hardware acceleration for encoding. So just click here, export, and then you will see it is fast. Nice. Here, finished video. This is what we do. If you want to have the free license and you want to register this software with free license, then you put the email address here and the license code here. But if you don't have it, just get one for free. Get a license for free. Put your email address here. Okay, put your email, get free code now, yes, and then the free code is sent to your email address, click login, and then go to your email. Here it is, the license code, copy your license code, click here login, and now you are successfully registered. Okay, guys. Another thing I wanted to show you. If you go here on the VideoProc here at the top, so let's go here on the settings, and here on the settings we see the general options, also folder, one project folder, output folder, snapshot folder, because you can make some snapshot if you want from your video. You have timeline here. Here is the beautiful part of this software, because it automatically can understand your computer and can learn from your computer what the hardware do you have. So look at this. If you just click here, scan hardware, then this software, it will scan your hardware automatically, and then it will show up. Yes, we have here NVIDIA. In my case, is Quadro K 4200. We have also enabled hardware acceleration with CUDA. Click OK on this video and that's it. This is VideoProc Vlogger, guys. If you have any other questions, just write me a comment on the comment area. I really like this software. It's easy. It don't need that much skills to use it. If you see my video tutorial, you can use it very easily after that. So thank you guys for watching. We will see you on the next video tutorial. And don't forget to subscribe. Tips to fix. Blessings.